Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at using a MOSFET to allow the flipper zero to control higher voltage and higher current devices. In our first example, we'll use a flipper zero plus a MOSFET to activate a 12 volt car alarm. In our second example, the flipper zero uses MOSFETs to inject Wiegand signals on a security system without needing any inline resistors. This makes our attack easier to deploy and harder to detect. Alright, let's get started. This is the diagram from the flipper0.1 website showing how the different pins on the flipper zero are connected. So you can see here PA7 goes to PA7, PA6 to PA6, etc. Each of the pins are protected by a TVS trans voltage suppressor, which clamps the input voltage to 5.5 volts. Each pin also has a 51 ohm resistor in series with it. For this video, I used an IRF 540, which is an N-channel power MOSFET. If you're using more than 1 amp of current, it's also recommended that you apply a heatsink. And the IRL 520 and 540 are logic level, so those would be most appropriate for using on the flipper zero. And depending on your load, a MOSFET driver might also be a good choice. And if your switching is slow, like less than a couple kilohertz, you might want to look at using an optocoupler as well to help protect the flipper even more. With those disclaimers out of the way, let's look at the IRF 540. So we have a gate, a drain, and a source pin. So our flipper's output pin is going to connect into the VN. That's going to give us 3.3 volts. You'll recall there's a 51 ohm resistor on the flipper. And then we're going to add another 200 ohms. So that gives us 250 ohms. And then we'll add a 5K pull-down resistor going to ground. We'll connect the source pin of the MOSFET directly to ground. And then our drain pin will connect to our load, which is either the negative of the car alarm or our D0 and D1 wires for the Wiegand control. So I think it's helpful to think of the MOSFET as a switch where your source is connected to ground. And then when the gate voltage is high enough, then the source and the drain are connected together. So now that drain is actually ground, when we have our drain going to our car alarm and then to the 12 volts, then the car alarm will turn on and we can use the drain to pull this 5 volt down to 0 volts on the D1 wire. So the drain pulls the D1 to 0. So the 12 volt power supply is going to go to the positive of our car alarm, and then that negative of the car alarm is going to go to the drain wire on our MOSFET. The red wire connects pin A7 from the Dolphin board to the MOSFET's gate pin. Instead of this wire, I'd recommend a 200 ohm resistor, and then we have our 5K pull down to ground. Our source pin goes to ground. When the MOSFET turns on, it's going to ground the negative of the car alarm. And our power supply is also connected to ground. So we'll use the GPIO app to output to pin A7. And for a short amount of time, we just activated a 14 watt alarm. I'm still learning, so I didn't know about the MOSFET driver at the time of this video. And it was just a few seconds, so I didn't connect the heatsink either. In this example, we have the Wiegand wires. We have our green, our white, and our ground. And then we have the two MOSFETs. So the one MOSFET's gonna pull our white wire, and the other one is pulling our green wire to ground. So A7 is our white wire, and then A6 is the yellow wire that's going to connect to the MOSFET to also pull that white wire to ground. A4 is our green wire, and then the red wire is going to pull it to ground. In my previous Wiegand video, we had this inline resistor that we were using, and that helped us be able to use the flipper to pull the pins to ground. When I send a signal, you'll see in the oscilloscope that the line goes down to ground. Now we'll remove the resistor by connecting an alligator clip to both sides. And this time you'll notice that the flipper zero is not able to pull the signal all the way to ground due to the 51 ohm internal resistance in the flipper. Now we'll connect our MOSFET. The gate goes to the PA6 pin of the flipper, and the drain is going to the PA7 or the white D1 wires. So now when we send the signal, you'll notice that it goes all the way to ground. Hopefully you now have a better idea of how to use a MOSFET to drive a large voltage or current load and how to overcome the 51 ohm internal resistor limitation. Please like and subscribe. Perhaps in a future video, we can look at MOSFET drivers and optocouplers to help keep your Flipper Zero fully protected. Leave a comment below if you're interested in me making a video on that.